welcome. You're watching drummerconnection.com. Today we're taking a look at halftime shuffle number one, workout number five. We're at the end of our journey with the halftime shuffle number one. This shuffle pattern just simply does that, shuffles on the hi-hat with no ghost notes on the snare drum and just a nice solid rim shot on beat three. What we've done is set up this hand pattern to keep it nice and consistent, and then over these series of four and now the fifth final workout, we're slowly introducing eighth note triplet rhythms on the bass drum, again keeping the hands consistent. We've eased into this, we looked at just the quarter note along with the last triplet, then we introduced the first and last triplet, then we introduced the middle triplet, then we introduced the last two triplets, and finally today we're going to look at the first two triplets. So that's the focus of what's going on today. As always, grab the PDF file from drummerconnection.com/drumlessons and print it and get it in front of you. We're going to work out of this thing like a method book. So let's get started. I'm going to give you an example now of number one. And here's what PDF download rhythm number five sounds like. Now you notice for the slower example that I'm playing for you guys, you'll hear eighth note triplets actually in the click playing that steady flow underneath. It can be a little tedious, a little annoying sometimes having that, but at slower tempos, I'm a big fan of using that because when things slow down and you have that steady flow right there clicking away, it's a great thing to cling to line your notes up to really practice accuracy. Like I said, it can be a little annoying, but it's great to use at slower tempos. Then obviously when you pick it back up to faster tempos, just go to a quarter note pulse and everything will shift faster but stay right in time. So here's another example now, here's number seven. And now let's move down to the final example. Here's a look at number 12. So there's the final workout for halftime shuffle number one. We've covered all of the possibilities in triplet world on the bass drum, including the middle triplet, along with the first two and the last two. It's a lot of fun stuff, challenging stuff, but I love to introduce all of this with no ghost notes so you can get a good feeling for where the bass drum's falling. We're going to continue this journey. We're going to start adding some ghost notes. You guys be sure and check out halftime shuffle number two. Thanks.